So how does it, as a founder, that you can actually build already such an advanced MVP?
Maybe in one word, I would say it's empowering, because really my background is in business and strategy. And I never saw myself as a full stack engineer or a data engineer. And being able to build something that is actually my vision into a tangible product, it's amazing. And as I said before, being able to test my assumptions in not something that it is looks nice, but it's not functional, it's great.
Hello and welcome to another 9X demo. My name is Jan. I'm one of the co-founders of 9X. Now, usually on this channel, we invite different no-code tools on to demo their product. But today we have a very special demo in store, and we're actually joined by a startup founder who is using no-code tools to build their MVP. So very happy to welcome Carol. Carol, founder of Velulo. How are you doing?
Yeah, hi, Jan. Many thanks for having me. Very happy to be here.
Nice. Yeah, great to have you on. So maybe before we get into the demo of your MVP, which I'm very excited about, you could tell us a little bit about what you guys are doing at Velulo.
So Velulo solves cycling for families. So what does it mean? So what we do is we make it more accessible for parents to access bikes for the kids. So the problem that we're trying to solve is that everyone knows cycling is awesome. Everyone wants to get a bike for their kids. But actually, the process of getting a bike is very complicated. You never know when your child is ready to get a bike. Bikes are growing extremely quickly. So actually, 6 bikes in 10 years is quite a lot of money that parents have to spend on. And the flexibility of a bike is you buy it, then you have the hassle of reselling, hassle of repairing. I know that adds a lot of complexity to actually getting a kid on wheels. So our platform actually facilitates bike subscriptions. So you as a parent have the convenience of always getting a bike on a monthly basis, and you can easily basically exchange them as your kid grows. We do it with a local first approach. So basically, if you are a parent in a neighborhood in Berlin and there's a bike shop in the corner of your street, you can actually go there, and instead of having to buy a bike that you're not really sure if your kid's going to use it or for how long he's going to have it, you can just go there and rent it out as a subscription. So that's what we do, and we facilitate that through a digital platform.
Very cool, very cool. So a digital platform you mentioned there, obviously. Now, I guess a lot of startups would go down the route of maybe like traditional development for building such a platform. What made you guys choose the no-code approach, at least for your MVP?
I think the key word here is MVP. What we need to do is test fast, fail fast, and onboard clients as soon as possible so that we can learn what works best for them. So I think using no-code tools is a very easy approach, like the getting the low-hanging fruits for testing all of our assumptions.
Very cool. Awesome. Then I think let's get straight into it. Let's jump into the demo. Nice.
Welcome to Velulo. As I already explained, we make kids' bikes better. So you as a parent, imagine you're a parent and you're looking for a bike for your kid. So what do you do? Can just directly go to bikes, and you can discover what are the bikes available near you. So all of our bikes are actually not owned by Velulo, but they are owned by the local partners. So we have a double-sided platform where we connect local shops with parents. So each of these bikes is offered by a shop in your vicinity. So that's also the value proposition that they have. It's nothing that would be too far for you to go, but it's something that is available near you. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on this one bike because my kid is 5 years old and I just want to see what they have to offer. So here you can quickly check how the bike look like, what's got the specifications. This I already see that is a pre-loved bike. So that means that it's a bike that has already been used by another kid. And that's actually a big plus. And that's why we work with local partners so that they can refurbish them really well. You can see what is the monthly subscription price. So here, if you go for a 2-year subscription, you pay only 15 euros per month. That is a very low threshold for anyone wanting to access a very high quality bike. Or you could also get it for a 9-month subscription, and also for 17 euros, we believe that is a very accessible price. So what you do here, you basically type your details. Yeah, Andy, and I live in the neighborhood of Mitte in Berlin. And this is my email, so andy@gmail.com. And then you can basically just directly, book a test ride. And yeah, you're basically on the waitlist to start getting your bike. So that's basically how it works for any family that wants to use our service. So as I said, you search around you, you test the bike, then at the shop you subscribe, and then once anything happens, you can basically support an exchange for a larger model directly at your local shop. Now going into the other side of the platform, which is for the providers. So what you need to do is you need to complete a sign up process. So I basically already have an account here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use it. And I'm quickly gonna show how it works. So first of all, shops need to digitize their inventory. That means they need to post the bike. That's the language that we use for shops. So you post the bike and you say, hey, I have these bikes from type, so I'm gonna have a model 920. The brand is type. It's a 20-inch bike, starter bike. It's green. So all of these fields are standard fields for kids' bicycles. So you always have to know what is the rider height, what is the inner length of the rider, and you can then upload the images that would go with the bike. And this is the retail price, so for how much you sell the bike. So this one, I'm just gonna suggest it costs 500 euros. And that's it. You have basically
super simple
posted your first bike. What happens is that you could basically look at your inventory here, and then you see, hey, there's something wrong with the bike. You could just quickly just have a look at it here and edit the bike. Any features that you think are not okay, you can do it. But most importantly, you can also say, hey, this bike is new, or this bike is pre-loved, as I already explained. So a bike that has already been going through a cycle of subscription, and whether it's available in maintenance, subscribed, or offline. So this bike is right now available, so I'm gonna update it. You can also, if you don't wanna have this bicycle anymore within your inventory, you can delete it. And then back here, it's just quicker ways of accessing it. So now I'm just gonna go directly into the user side, and I'm gonna see that this bike is right now also available. So everything is extremely easy. It's a quick interface where the starting effort for a bike shop is almost none.
Very cool. And maybe, so obviously what we've seen there is already a live website application. You've got some user login behavior where your bike shops can log in. And then you've also got the front end side for the customers where users can join a wait list. So can you tell us what was the stack you chose to build out this already quite advanced application that you have?
Yeah, we have a very simple stack. We're using Airtable as our back end, Softr as the front end, and we are automating some of these things using Make.
All right, so we got a very good sense of what the product is capable of. Do you mind sharing us a little bit of under the hood what the setup looks like within your Softr app and within Airtable?
Yeah, absolutely. So maybe just going here on our Softr app, this is the front end. It's extremely easy to use. So I think one of the pages that I would like to show you where basically the core of what Velulo is, the bikes database. So here I just linked my Airtable to Softr. I told it, okay, which database it is, which table I need, and what kind of view I need to have. Also depending on who is the user, if it's a logged in user or non-logged in user, I could also very easily set that up. And in terms of the content, so as you can see, these are just like chips or individual cards, and it's very easy to customize. And for me, it was very important that the customers could see a photo of the bike, the status. So for example, if it's offline, online, in maintenance, what's the name of the bike, the model, what is the recommended age, because that's how parents work. You basically put your kid into a block, and that's where they stay, the size, and also what's the price. Easily, I could also include other fields which could be relevant. So for example, I don't know what color it is, but that is actually not relevant if you already have the photo. And then in actions, so I only enabled for the parents a quick view because I don't want them to do anything else right there.
Maybe I think that's definitely one of the main benefits of Softr is that, as you mentioned, you now have access to be able to control the different users logging in. Also, not just the login of users, but to actually set different permissions depending on, is it a parent viewing a certain object or is it actually the owner of the shop who's viewing that same object? They have a totally different set of permissions. And typically this was something that only developers could do. So the fact that Softr has made this available to us business people, it really gives us a lot of possibility in terms of what we can build.
Exactly. Yeah. So it's really just a click of a button. Who can see it? All users or only logged in or not logged in users. And then basically in the inventory side, it's this the exact same table, but here had a different logic because I needed the shops to be able to edit the inventory and update the status. So as you see, it's the same base, the same table, but this is now filtered by who is the shop. So because in my database, I have a lot of shops and it's just one table with all of the inventory, what I need to see is who is actually posting that bike. So it's Circular Rocks, is it Velulo Test, is it Best Bikes Since Forever? So all of that you could easily just filter here. And that's something that is also the core to being able to manage your shop. And it follows the same logic. So what do I want to show the shops? What kind of actions do they act and do they have access to? And what visibility is it then out for them? And just, it's like a quick page navigation here, same as you would have with any website builder. You have different pages. So I have families side. I have a form here. So whenever I want to capture anyone's email, it's very easy. I have it here and there's a data source I connected it to. So it's this base. There's a table that is the sign up, test sign up. So here in my Airtable, I also have one board where I collect all of those emails.
Very cool.
So I'm really happy with the setup. I think for what I need right now, it's perfect. I think if I needed to scale it a bit bigger, I probably need to look a bit closer into what are the possibilities. But so far, so good.
Awesome. And do you already have in mind, have you got some, so eventually when the waitlist time is over and people are actually subscribing to the bikes and paying that monthly fee, have you already got a solution in mind to handle that part?
Yeah, actually, good point. So we also already have Stripe Connect, which is a payment platform that facilitates two-sided platform business models. So we also have the onboarding already as part of the stack. We don't have it live because we don't want to already show that in case there's any payments going through the platform, but we already have that application onboarded.
Very cool. Very cool. And maybe you can just tell us, like, how has this changed things for you as a founder? So one thing you haven't mentioned is that most of this you've built by yourself. You've obviously got a team as well, but you've been the main person building this. So how does it, as a founder, that you can actually build already such an advanced MVP? It's obviously it's an MVP, but it's quite advanced without necessarily needing to rely on engineers or developers to support you and actually bringing your dream into a reality.
Maybe in one word, I would say it's empowering. Because really my background is in business and strategy, and I never saw myself as a full stack engineer or a data engineer, and being able to build something that is actually my vision into a tangible product, it's amazing. And as I said before, being able to test my assumptions in not something that looks nice, but it's not functional, it's great. It's been actually not too long. It didn't take so long for me to learn how to use these tools. It's quite self-explanatory once you like get the gist of it, and it's been great. So now I can actually not have the necessity to already onboard a developer or rely on developers for the beginning, but can build something myself and eventually onboard someone else into the team who can help me build a more robust platform once the volume starts to kick on.
Yeah, awesome. And so you mentioned right now you are just based in Berlin. I think it's important. Maybe you can also share the URL, the website for anyone in Berlin who's interested in checking out your site.
Yeah, so right now we're based out in Berlin. We are growing. We have basically our growth trajectory for the future will be we grow kids by kids, so neighborhood by neighborhood, city by city, and country by country. Right now in Berlin, because we need to grow a critical mass with bike shops. That's why we're only here. If you want to visit or learn more about our company, you can go to velulo.com. That is velulo.com.
Perfect. And I will be sure to also leave a link in the description below this video for anyone who wants to check it out. Carol, thank you so much for that demo. It's very cool to see what you've already built, and we'll definitely be keeping an eye on what's coming up next for Velulo. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you, Jan.